13 years ago, you caught my eye, and you've never left my mind since. No matter what happens in my day, I know that when I come home to you, everything will be all right. I vow to always finish your last couple bites of dinner, to support you when your days are tough, and to celebrate all of the amazing things that you do. My easiest vow of all is that I vow to love you with everything that I have for the rest of my life. 13 years ago, I knew it was you, and it has always been you, and it will always be you.
Kevin, I stand in front of you so happy that we've made it here. You are beyond my best friend, the absolute king of persistency, and the goofiest boy that I've ever known. I absolutely promise to try to be the best mother to our future children. And I promise to be there for every good day, every renovation project, but maybe not every hockey game, because I swear there's more of those. But more importantly, I promise to be there when the days are shit, the haircuts are bad, and the distance between us are long, with a cup of tea and a stand on your toes hug. My Kevin head, I love you, and I'm so excited for our future.
Five-and-a-half-year age difference, Sid was the little sister, the tag-along, the bat girl at my baseball, the kid who couldn't quite keep up with the big kids. But looking back, I wouldn't trade any of those memories, and she's now my best friend. She was my maid of honor, twice, godmother, and best auntie, but don't tell my husband's sister that. And she's the most amazing sister anyone could ask for. I'm so proud of the woman you are, the brilliant, kind, stubborn, emotional woman that married her best friend. A little sister who puts in work in all aspects of her relationship and in her life, and only complains slightly when Kevin doesn't let her sleep in till awkwardly. But let's bring Kevin into this speech, because he's kind of important too.
Not only do you support Sid, but you make her happy. Sid, I cannot thank you enough for taking care of my baby sister.
So thank you for joining our family and being another little brother.
A little bit of history about me and Kev. We actually met when we were about 4 years old at the Lloyd Wilson Hockey Arena in Inglewood. And I guess you can say that's where Kevin found his first true love that we all know, the game of hockey. Kevin, you are truly the most kind, honest, selfless, loving person I know. And you're always someone that I can count on. You've taught me so much on how to be a better person and to always look at the positives in life. I'm so happy to have the opportunity to have a front row seat on your relationship with Sydney. And as your best man standing here today, I can tell you that you're sitting beside your best friend.
Today we gather to give recognition to the worth and the beauty of love and the life that Kevin and Sydney are building together. You're the honored family that have walked with them through the joys and the challenges to get to this moment today. You've come from different backgrounds and you've walked different paths. You're different individuals, but your love has transcended these differences. May the challenges of your life be met with courage and optimism. May you learn from your failures and grow in your achievements. May life bless you with children, friends, and family in a wide community of support and enjoyment. And may the spirit of love be ever a part of your lives so that this union that we're celebrating here today be worthy of continued celebration tomorrow and the next day.
Arms, let me lay down beside you. Let me always be with you. Come, let me love you. Come, love me again.
You fell in love by chance, but you're here today because you're making a choice. You're both choosing each other. You've chosen to be with someone who enhances you, who makes you think, who makes you smile, and makes every day brighter. And so, Kevin, will you keep Sydney as the favorite person in your life? To laugh with her, go on adventures with her, support her through life's tough moments, be proud of her, grow old together, and find new reasons to love her every day.
I will.
And will you, Sydney, keep Kevin as the favorite person in your life? To laugh with him, go on adventures with him, support him through life's tough moments, be proud of him, grow old together, and find new reasons to love him every day.
I will.
And now the moment that you've been waiting for. Kevin and Sydney, you've made your vows to each other before those gathered here, and you've confirmed those beautiful promises by the joining of hands and the exchanging of rings. Therefore, by the authority given me by the province of Ontario, I pronounce that you are now husband and wife, and you may kiss because we want to celebrate with you. And now it is a very great honor to present to you, appearing for the very first time anywhere as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Boyd.
You all heard the story about Kevin, Sid, and everybody knows how good they are together. They really are good together. They're going to rule the world, these two. Once Sid is done her schooling, once Kevin puts his mind to something, they're going to rule the world, I swear to God. They're going to rule the world.
Our rental is now owner. Kevin knows what that means.
Kevin, you are resilient and determined, smart and outgoing, proving you can be successful in anything you attempt, even through adversity and challenge. Your brother is surely proud of you, and so are we. We are so very excited for what the future has in store for you, and we were thrilled to be along for the ride. Cheers to Kevin and Sydney.
Anyone that knows me knows how long I've been waiting for this moment. This has been a long time coming for me. Like I said, it was 13 years ago when I was sitting on the bag box backyard at pool party, sitting beside my best man Mitch, and I see this hot blonde girl come walking in. I'm like, who is that? And he's like, that's Sydney Morris. And then for the rest of the day, we were hitting it off, playing Mankind. She's throwing my towel in the pool, getting in trouble, and then she was the first one to message me on Facebook, so really, it was friend zone and new year.
Smokes, we're married.